name is Armstrong Sass, and it's been a really long time I came on YouTube. I've missed you guys a whole lot. If you missed me, let me know in the comment section. I got a lot of messages and I got a lot of Armstrong, I've missed you, when I drop the next video. Well, this is the next video, and I thought to address something very particular about our field, smudge painting. Mistakes smudge painters make, obviously the dumbest mistakes smudge painters make. Hi, my name is Armstrong Sass, and if you are just coming to this channel for the first time, welcome to this channel. I teach a lot of things, smudge paints, whatever it is. If you go to my old video, you see I teach every single thing there is to teach, and I'm a vlogger too. So you might want to hit the subscribe button and have a chill time with me. Without further ado, let's dive right to this video. Let's put some energy. Well, in a nutshell, first of all, the first thing you need to consider when you are a smudge painter is you are more of a professional photo editor than a painter, a digital painter. Now, this is why I said that, because a lot of mistakes people make is because they take away the fact that they are just photo editors. You're not drawing with your hands from the scratch. I respect those that do that a whole lot. So one of the mistakes smudge painters make is the fact that they make this mistake and they feel like, I'm just doing art on Photoshop. Stupid. First thing, don't use blurry pictures. Using blurry pictures is going to ruin whatever you are doing. It's going to ruin it so much. Now, a picture from WhatsApp is going to reduce your quality. A picture from Facebook would even be times two blurrier than any other picture you have ever seen. A picture from Instagram is going to be clearer than the one from WhatsApp. Now, a picture from Telegram, it's going to be a whole lot better than WhatsApp. Now, that's because these different platforms have different ways of saving or storing up images. So you should try to look for the one that I would especially advise Twitter and Telegram to share pictures or to get references from. So if you're working for a client, please tell them to get you pictures through your email. That's the best place you can get. Or if you want to get references, try getting from Instagram. Use an Instagram downloader to get these things. Don't be like me that was screenshotting it and I turned up with something very blurry. The second point that really bothers me is the fact that some images turn out too sharp because of the high pass law of percentage on them, and they turn out to have these beards that have this earthworm feel on it. No, that's not right. The hair and the brush and whatever you are using should make these pictures turn out very realistic and not too sharp. Now, if a picture is too blurry, that's bad. Now, when it's too sharp, it's even worse, because you see a picture and there's something about the picture that just itches your body. Now, I've seen a lot of them on Instagram. A lot of persons do this. You're a professional, you're a pro. For you to be on this channel means you're a pro, and that's one thing you should try not to do. Avoid too much high pass on your image. A challenge was thrown out to a WhatsApp group. I actually have a little WhatsApp group, very small. WhatsApp has a limit to a lot of persons that can be on a group, so I have a very small WhatsApp group, and I threw out a challenge to them. I wanted to see how far these guys are good with colors. And there's something we always forget, those that do smudge painting always forget, that this is a high-end manipulation. You're not sketching with your hands. So why give me an image that is going to make me look like an alien? Now, this is not Toy Story, or this is real image. So don't give me, get pictures of realistic skins. Use the same pictures, use the same image, compare them. That's why you need to be following me on Instagram. So if you're not following me on Instagram, don't forget to check out at Armstrong Sass. And I've started dropping educational things that you should check out about how to add hair strands to your image. You check out what I've done before, compare these two. That's how to work, that's how to get better. You compare what I've done before and what you are doing now, just compare them and then check out what works for you and what you think is going to be very, very good for you. Also, tell me what you think. Do you think I should probably create a Telegram group like somebody suggested that's going to contain a whole lot of persons, that you get to have a smudge painting community? Your wish is my command, because I might not be online every time. So, and number four, take out your time to smudge these jobs. Take out time to give us something nice. Wow me, wow Armstrong. And a lot of persons tag me on Instagram and then they tag me for something that is not so mind-blowing. I want to be blown out. I want to be blown away. When I'm blown away, I'll follow you. When I'm blown away, I'll comment. Now, it's not about me. It's about dropping something that you've taken out your time to do. And you can't take out your time to do when you're smudge painting very fast. That's one of the issues, biggest issues I think a lot of persons have. Now, you come out with a picture where this place looks so smudged out. No, you want to take out your time. Make the smudge brush very, very low. And then if you're asking, you don't have the smudge brush like a lot of persons have been asking me now. I don't know if it's here or it's here, I don't know. But one of them is where you can click on and then you get my previous video about how to get the smudge brush. It's free. The video has pretty much blown up over 20,000 views. But you can as well check it, download the brush. That took me roughly 6, 7, 8, 10 months, 1 year to get. And I'm giving that for free. So take it out. Take out time and smudge all these places properly. You notice that, wow, we are going to have a nice time. I have a lot of videos about how to smudge, so you might want to check that out by yourself. Now, finally, the fifth tip. One thing a lot of persons get to ignore is the background. Now, this is a perfect illustration. Just watch. Now, I'm in a room, my room. And then the back is white, even if I can't see, so I'm just giving something. Now the back is white and I'm wearing a black shirt. Now get this, my air condition is there and it's white, and then I have a cupboard here, and that this gives you a feel of how your background should be. This is like a natural setting. Now don't give me, I could have worn a white shirt. If I worn a white shirt, it's going to turn out, it's going to conflict with the background. So don't give me a background that is too bright and it will conflict with the back. Now you want to give me something that is going to blend in. You want to make the background not so bright, that will blend in, and then you want to give me something very, very, very nice done. I have a lot of backgrounds and I'll be sharing that how I get backgrounds. So okay, first off, you can get backgrounds from pixels.com. tell me if you want me to dedicate a video about how I get backgrounds and how I shop for backgrounds for totally free. You know, I'm like a cool guy, so it's totally free. Well, you can get background from pixels.com, from Google. Just get backgrounds. Google, there are a lot of things you can Google. Get good backgrounds. Search for the kind of backgrounds that I use. Get gradient backgrounds. Those things will work. Plain background still would work if it blends with your image. Pretty much the whole thing. And then I think I want to do a video about how to sell your ads. I mean, after getting all these things, I become a pro. How to really sell them. Now, if you love this video and you really watch to this extent and you think this video is helpful to you, why don't you hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, drop a comment. If you're watching it off YouTube, why don't you go to YouTube and drop a comment? It's going to suggest this video to other persons, and YouTube is going to be like, oh yeah, this guy does a whole lot of nice things. That's like the least thing you can do. So, pretty much it. Tell me what you think about this video. What do you think? Do you think I should create a Telegram group? Do you think I should keep posting this kind of videos? Do you think I should just be on my system and record just my voice? Do you think you don't see my face? Do you think I should lose this? I should lose this. I don't know.